Manu Dibango is the most sampled African artist of all time. Sample Chief has over 125 samples and covers on record, with the actual number estimated to be much higher. From the Soul Sonic Forces 1983 track, Renegades of Funk, to Busta Rhymes Keeping It Tight. Cop the hot shit, big up my nigga Primo. Hey, son. Stack loot with my nigga Dino and Nino. Julio, Cliff, and my other nigga Digo. Manu Dibango was born in Cameroon in 1933. At 15, he left to study in France, where he picked up the saxophone and piano while in school. Inspired by the jazz performance he had watched, he began performing at clubs in Belgium. He got the attention of the Congolese orchestra, African Jazz, and began touring with them. In 1965, he returned to France and played in ballrooms in the lively Pigalle neighborhood in Paris. He was discovered by French performers Dick Rivers and Nino Ferrer, who eventually gave him his own show. In 1972, he recorded Soul Makossa. It was a B-side he made for the African Cup of Nations, which was hosted by Cameroon. While Cameroon unfortunately lost the tournament, the song itself was a winner. The following year saw a wave of African Americans who wanted to embrace their African roots, come to France in search of music from the motherland. They took Manu's record back with them, and thanks to New York DJs David Mancuso and Frankie Crocker, the track became a massive hit. Because there weren't very many copies of Soul Makossa released, pretty much every band recorded their own cover of the song. At one point, there were 9 different versions of Soul Makossa on the Billboard charts. It was even the inspiration behind 3 Kool & the Gang records, including Funky Stuff and Hollywood Swinging. Multiple sections of the track have been sampled, but let's start with the drums, which were widely sampled in 90s hip-hop records. House music in your face, grab yourself a partner, find a space on the dance floor, here's your chance for jumping and bumping, I'm pumping. Next are the samples of the jazzy horn sections.
So wake up world and bust out my new single. I take dead parties and I boost them up live. So straighten up and be alert because the rulers arrive. No.
I sold a lot of records and a lot of people know me. Now where's my goddamn trophy?
And the winner is George Strait
for best female vocalist.
Scattered around, but never seen with it.
Pack down,
check for cream in it.
These riches
got nothing to do with these bitches.
Nothing y'all can do to stop these digits.
Back the house, y'all.
back at the house, y'all.
Finally, the vocals. This chant, that was first used jokingly, became one of the most popular interpolations in contemporary music. It became even more popular when it was famously used on Michael Jackson's 1982 classic, Wanna Be Starting Something, and later by Rihanna on her 2007 hit, Don't Stop the Music.
MJ and Rihanna were later sued for using it without permission. The case was first settled out of court, but was later ruled inadmissible as Dibango had already waived his rights to legal action.
Here are some tracks that have used this popular interpolation.
Mama say ya, Mama Kusa gets hectic, freak a bourgeois.
Mama come closer in the middle of the club with the
say, Mama say, Mama Kusa.
Mama say, Mama say, Mama Kusa.
Mama say, Mama say, Mama Kusa.
Mama say, Mama say, Mama Makossa. Lost in this plastic life.
Mama say, Mama say, Mama Makossa. I supply the real shit when hip hop go dry.
Mama say, Mama say, Mama Makossa.
But I eat you recess bar. Mama say, Mama say, Mama Makossa.
Mama say, Mama say, Mama Makossa. Don't make sense, but admit it is kinda hot.
That Charles Hamilton line aptly expresses how many listeners feel about the iconic hook. The catchy interpolation has continued to transcend genres, countries, and time periods. While So Makossa is Dibango's most celebrated song, earning him 2 Grammy nominations, his catalogue extends far beyond it. He was one of the first African artists to be recognized internationally, releasing over 70 albums in a career spanning 6 decades. A model for innovation and longevity in the music industry, he will be remembered as the artist who introduced the world to the gift of Afro jazz.